The human genome accelerated our ability to understand the underlying changes in a variety of diseases. Opening a door to expand treatments with patients was a critical part of the next step.
TGen was the center of this great aspiration that we all had to make life in Arizona better for everybody and beyond.
There was the governor, there were Native American tribes, there were universities, people like John McCain. Basically, this eclectic group of disparate people built the start of what became TGen over 20 plus years. It was pretty clear that this was going to be something special and motivated them to raise over $100 million to get TGen started.
Everybody was inspired to be involved in some way. This was hands-on applied research that would benefit people immediately.
The genomic sequencing can happen. The part that is so important is who is reading that. And that is where TGen really shines. We have a grandson who was born with a very rare syndrome. The Center for Children with Rare Disorders was the first to examine him. C4RCD has been able to solve what is going on in a child. And these are families that have met dead ends for years, and that's where my real passion is.
My husband was diagnosed with brain cancer. He was living a very full and active life, and then he died in 4 months later. Brain cancer is not one disease. It is so unique to each body, each person. You need a map specific to a patient's disease. TGen provides the most detailed map that you can get. And it's this type of innovation that can save a person's life.
TGen works quickly, but with incredible precision to get things done to help people right now.
Today, TGen's genetic information is so much more advanced to categorize different subtypes of cancer and be more targeted in helping people cure their disease.
We did not come close 20 years ago in visualizing all that would be accomplished in the next two decades. The reduction in the cost from billions of dollars for a single genome now to a few hundred dollars. 10 years to complete the first genome, 10 hours and less to complete a genome today. These are now common occurrences.
Both TGen and City of Hope share an overwhelming sense of urgency. With a built-in default to speed, this system is helping make science practical.
Virginia really believed that quality health care was important to everyone, regardless of their economic status. We see them as continuing to make scientific breakthroughs with intentionality that all people are included in the benefits of their research.
City of Hope is creating a cancer research and treatment system to expand access to specialty cancer care and remove barriers for patients, particularly those in underserved communities.
Tremendous joy being able to help populations that are underserved, underrepresented, and positive opportunities we have there.
TGen's been the leader of biomedical research, and they keep getting more and more advanced.
They were the pioneer. They started the process. If you think about that horizon, where that's going to go in terms of that research, it's really extraordinary.
There's so many important things that TGen is doing that will help personalize medicine better for the future.
We've really made a difference.
We are looking forward to a long and continued relationship with TGen, knowing that they are really on the forefront of high-impact research.
It's not just Arizona, it's not just the United States, it's the entire world that benefits from the work that TGen has done.
The translational aspects of TGen's research, fused with the strength of City of Hope's research and clinical excellence, have enabled us to create a cancer research and treatment system that few, if any, providers can match. The best is yet to come.
20 years ago, the vision of translating the genomic information of a patient for treatment of their disease was just that, a vision. But 20 years later, that vision is reality, and TGen, which has been accelerated now by being a part of City of Hope, continues to be on the vanguard of this field of medicine.